This week on The Wire, first home buyers buoyed by grants and low rates, investors turn to smaller cities, and confidence in housing market booms. G'day guys, my name's Tim Guest and welcome to The Wire, the week in real estate. We can get all the top stories happening this week in finance, real estate, investment and more. Now please like, comment, share this video, and if it's your first time tuning in, don't forget to follow or subscribe wherever you are seeing this. So our top story for this week, first home buyers buoyed by grants and low rates. So first home buyers are rushing into the property market, heartened by the fact that COVID-19 has not adversely affected the property industry and spurred on by low interest rates and government assistance. That's all coming from Bank of Queensland Chief Executive Jules Frazis. The Bank of Queensland reports its mortgage application volumes are back to pre-COVID levels, and Frazis says confidence has started to return to the industry. People are feeling more comfortable about how well the health crisis is being managed, he says. They're also feeling more comfortable about the stimulus. The government has done a really good job on both of those. Though house prices have dropped in Victoria and New South Wales, they have now stabilised and are even trending higher in Queensland, Western Australia and other states and territories. It's the low interest rates that are encouraging people to get into housing, Frazis says. It's just made it very affordable. High levels of government assistance are another key factor, plus the relatively low levels of competition from investors. And now, guys, for our next story. So investors turn to smaller cities. So smaller cities can expect an increase in demand from investors as the big cities lose their appeal in the wake of COVID-19. That's according to new research from CoreLogic. CoreLogic head of research, Eliza Owen, says COVID-19 triggered a retreat of investors from favoured markets like inner city Sydney and Melbourne. From an affordability and yield perspective, smaller capital city markets could grow in popularity with investors in the coming months, while the larger cities are unlikely to regain ground until overseas migration and travel resume, she says. At present, Brisbane, Perth, and Adelaide offer much higher yields than the southern capitals because of the lower dwelling values. The latest ABS housing finance data shows current investors' participation is just under a quarter, well below the decade average of 36%. Investor activity has been reduced because investor loans attract a higher interest rate. There is less appetite by lenders for higher LVR and interest-only lending, the reduction of rental returns in the big cities, and the shocks caused by the pandemic. Now, guys, moving on to our final last story of the week, confidence in housing market booms. So confidence in the Australian housing market is rising with a Westpac consumer survey revealing a strong uplift in consumer sentiment. The National House Price Expectations Index grew by a third to 117, with all states registering a double-digit increase. The National Time to Buy a Dwelling Index increased 11% in the past month to 122, rising to its highest level since December 2019. Westpac Chief Economist Bill Evans says it's an extraordinary result, stating the overall consumer sentiment index was up 32% in the past 2 months and 10% above the average level in the 6 months prior to the pandemic. Such a development must be attributable to the response to the federal budget, ongoing success across the nation in containing COVID-19 outbreak, and the expectation that Reserve Bank is likely to further cut interest rates at its next meeting on November 3rd. There was also a stunning lift in confidence around job security, says Evans, with the index improving by 14 to early 2019 levels. Well, guys, they're our top stories for this week. Now, please don't forget to like, comment, and share this video, and follow or subscribe wherever you're seeing this. Have a great week, and remember, there is only one thing in life that makes a difference, and that's action. Thanks a lot, guys. Have a great week, and bye for now.